continuation with the engineering curves, in the previous lecture, you have already learned about the introduction to the engineering curves, classification of the curves, and you have learned in detail the ellipse, that is conical type of curves. Today, we are going to learn more about the parabola and hyperbola, the conical type of curves. We are quickly revising the few important points of the conics. Definition, as all of you are knowing, that it is the locus of a point moving in a plane such that ratio of its distance from fixed point to fixed line is always remains constant for the all conics. And fixed line is known as directrix, and fixed point is known as focus. And the curve which is generated by the point is the conics. Here the vertex V is plotted and this conical shape of curve is drawn. This is the point P whose locus is moving in a plane such that the ratio of distance from fixed point to fixed line always remains constant. This is the distance you can measure from a fixed line and fixed point. That ratio of a distance from a fixed point, that is focus, and distance from a fixed line, that is directrix, is known as eccentricity. How you are obtaining the conics, that also you have already learned. We are revising. If the cutting plane is inclined to the axis, the end also cut the generator, the section you will get, that is ellipse. If the cutting plane is inclined to the axis but parallel to the generator, then the section you will get is the parabolic curve. And if the cutting plane is parallel to the axis, then the section you will get, that is hyperbolic curve, hyperbola. Now learning the parabola in detail, when the cutting plane is inclined to the axis and parallel to the one of its generator, then parabolic section of the curve you will get. Here again the cutting plane which cuts the cone, and the section you will get the parabolic curve. And in terms of directrix and focus, in terms of eccentricity, the definition for the parabola, it is the locus of a point moving in a plane such that its distance from a fixed point to fixed line in case of parabola is always 1. That is, distance from a fixed point, this distance from a fixed point and distance from a fixed line, these two distance here, MP and PF, both are equal. So eccentricity in the case of parabolic curve is equal, 1. Quickly see the uses of parabolic curve, why we are learning the parabola. So in the practical applications of the parabolic curve is the motor car, headlamp reflector, sound reflector, bridge and arches constructions, shape of cooling tower, path of particle. If any particle thrown in the sky and when it is coming back again to the ground, that is, it is thrown in the sky against the gravity and coming back to the ground, it will follow, while returning to the ground, it will follow the parabolic path. Now methods of construction of parabola, one by one I will explain the different methods of construction of parabola. We are going to learn about the four methods of construction of parabola: rectangle method, parabola in parallelogram, tangent method of construction of parabola and directrix focus method for the construction of parabola. First, we will see the rectangle method for the construction of parabola through one example. This is a one example. The ball is thrown in the air. It attains the 100 meter height and covers the horizontal distance 150 meter on the ground. Now, I would like to here mention that if anything is thrown in the sky against the gravity and while returning, it is returning back on the ground, it always follows the parabolic path. So, sometimes students may ask to draw the parabolic path other way, not actually the given to the problem that you draw the path of ball, you draw the path of stone like that. But when it is in the sky and it is returning to the ground, then it always follows the parabolic path. So we'll construct the parabola here by rectangle method. Ball attains the 100 meter heights and it covers the horizontal distance of 150 meter. That means the rectangle we will draw, that is of 100 by 150. One side of the rectangle, that is of a horizontal distance it covers, that is 150 meter, and height it attains, that is 100 meter. So one side of rectangle will be of 100 meter, another side of the, that is this side, horizontal side of a rectangle will be of 150 meter. Then we will divide that rectangle into two equal division. We'll mark the ABCD for the rectangle and 0 and vertex V here for the middle partition. Now we will divide this both the part of the rectangle into number of equal division. Here the number of equal division is taken 6, but it is not necessary always to take the 6 division. You may divide into according to the dimension of the side, according to the measurement of the side of the rectangle. Not necessary every time to take the 6 equal division. You may take number of equal division according to the dimension of the rectangle, that is side. And here I would like to say that more number of points you will take, more accurate your curve will be. Similarly, other portion of the rectangle, that is other part of the side of rectangle, is divided into same number of equal division, and here you have to give the numbering from the inside, that is from 1, starting from 1 here from the inside, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, now we will divide the vertical side of the rectangle, same number of equal division. If you have taken the 6 here, then you have to divide the vertical side of the rectangle into 6 number of equal division. Here from the starting from the 0. So both the 6 will meet over here. Both the 6th part of the both the horizontal as well as vertical side will coincide. Then join all the points with this vertex V. Similarly, join all the points, draw a line joining from all the points. Now, draw a vertical line from a division from a 1. Wherever it intersects the line drawn from the 1, there will be a point on parabola like this, point P1. Then draw vertical line from a point 2. Wherever it intersects the line drawn from 2, that will be P2. Similarly, P3, P4, P5, and P6 is the point 6 itself. Similarly, towards this side, line drawn from 1, wherever it intersects the line drawn from 1, there will be intersection point will be the point on parabola. So you have obtained all the points on the parabola. Now you have to draw the smooth curve passing from all this point. While drawing the curve, you have to remember that in a single stroke, all the points are joined with the smooth curve. you need not have to dark it while drawing, or you need not have to draw again and again on the same line. You have to draw smooth curve in a single stroke to show the parabolic curve. Now, moving to the second method of construction of parabola, that is in the parallelogram. The construction methodology for the parallelogram method and rectangle method is similar. Here, the parallelogram is constructed at some angle. Here you can see now what is a parallelogram and what is the rectangle, what is the difference. Here also we are having a two parallel sides. The dimensions of the sides of a parallelogram will remain same. Here 100 meter and 150, 100 meter by 150 meter, same way. Whatever the two sides are given in the case of rectangle, similarly two sides will be given in the parallelogram method. So the method for the construction of parabola for the rectangle as well as parallelogram will remain same. Same way we will divide the first the parallelogram into equal division, and then we'll take divide the horizontal line into same number of equal division on the both the side, then divide the vertical line, vertical side of the parallelogram into same number of equal division. Then draw the lines from all the points, that is line from 1 dash joining the V, that is vertex, line from 2 dash, so join the vertex with all the points. Similarly, towards this side, now here if I draw the line from 1 dash, wherever it intersects, the line drawn from 1 dash, the intersection point will give you the point on parabola. Then draw the line from 2 dash, 3 dash, wherever it intersects the line drawn from a vertical side. Here, the intersection point, you will get the point on the parabola. Remaining half construction you will do similar way. First join all the points on the vertical side, then draw the vertical lines from the division you have marked on the horizontal side, then draw line, vertical line, wherever it intersects the line drawn from same points, you will get the points on the parabola. Now you have obtained all the points on the parabola for the parabola, and you have to join again and again. I am telling you, you have to draw from all the points smooth curve with a single stroke. This is the parabolic construction by the parallelogram method. Now moving to the third methods of construction with the problem, that is construction of parabola by the tangent method, and we are taking the problem here to understand or to learn the third method of construction for the parabola. This is the problem: an isosceles triangle of 100 mm long base and 110 mm long altitude, and with the help we have to inscribe the parabola with the method of tangent. So tangent method of construction of parabola. First, according to the dimension, base is drawn, and according to the altitude, here 110 mm. This is isosceles triangle, so two sides of the triangle will remain same. Base is given to you. So construct the triangle according to the dimension. Here the V point is marked, that is a vertex, in the middle of the altitude. Now divide both the side of the triangle into number of equal division according to the dimension of the side of the triangle. You can divide into number of equal division, but here you have to remember that the numbering at one side from bottom to top, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and it ends at a 10 at a top. So on another side, you have to give the number reverse way. So same number of equal division, you have to divide both the side of a triangle. Then you have to join 1, 1, that is one point of this side and one point of this side. Similarly, you have to join 2, 2. And accordingly, you have to join all the points. So you have to draw the lines from one point on the same one side and the same one point on the other side. Similarly, you have to join all the lines, that is all the points you have to join by line. Now take one line and you have to go on drawing the curve such that it will become tangential to the all the line. That is, you start drawing the curve such that it will become tangentially. You have to draw a curve, small arc of tangential arc to all the lines, that is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, and then you will get a smooth curve, that is parabola. This is the tangent method for the construction of parabolic curve. And the last method, that is directrix focus method, I will explain with this example. That is, point F is 50 mm from the vertical straight line AB. Draw the locus of a point P moving in a plane such that it will always remain equal distance from the point F and line AB. Here I would like to mention here that distance of a moving point always remains same from a fixed point, that is known as focus, and fixed line, that is known as directrix. So for in the case of parabolic curve, this distance always remains same. That means eccentricity, that is ratio of its distance from a fixed point to fixed line, eccentricity, it is known, the ratio is known as eccentricity, and it is always equal to 1 in the case of parabola. So when you have to draw the locus of a point with ascent moving in a plane such that its eccentricity is 1, then you have to construct the parabola. And here we are going to learn the directrix focus method for construction of parabola. The directrix, first you have to draw one vertical line. Perpendicular to vertical line, we will draw the axis, that is one another line perpendicular to the directrix. On that, focus F is marked. Here for the problem, the distance between the directrix and focus is 50 mm given. So first we will mark the focus at a distance of 50 mm from the directrix. This is given to you. First, we have drawn the directrix. Perpendicular to the directrix, we have drawn one line that is known as axis of the parabola. On the axis, we have marked the first point F, that is known as focus, at a distance of 50 mm, which is given in the problem. Now, we will mark the midpoint, first point which come on the parabola. Where it can come? Always in the midpoint of RF. Why it will be in the midpoint of RF? Because distance from a fixed line, that is this, and distance from a fixed point is always remain same in the case of parabola. So first point V on the parabolic curve will be at a midpoint of RF, that is at the same distance from a fixed point and fixed line. So V point is a midpoint of RF. It is at the same distance from a fixed point and fixed line. Then we will take the number of points on the axis nearly at an equal distance. Then we will draw the vertical line from all the points. Here we have drawn the vertical line from all the points taken nearly at equal distance on the axis of the curve. Now, why we have drawn the vertical lines from all the points? What is the meaning why we are drawing the vertical lines? So here I can say that if I take any point on this line which is passing from a point 1, if I take any point on this line which is passing from a point 1, that all the points will be have a same distance from a fix. If I take any point on the line passing from a 1, this all the points will have a same distance from a fixed line. So any point on this line will have a distance r1 from a fixed line. All the points on the line which is passing from 1 will have a distance r1 from a fixed line. So I have to make sure that if I want to get the point on a parabolic curve, that is on the parabola, that will be at a same distance from a fixed point. So what now this distance is decided, which is from the fixed line, that is r1. So I have to make sure that the same r1 distance will remain if I take consider the point from the fixed point. So what I will take now, f as a center, radius equal to r1, I will cut an arc on this line. So that will be at a distance r1 from a fixed point, and r1, it is at a distance r1 from a fixed line. So when I am taking this at a distance f as a center, radius equal to r1, wherever it cuts this line, that will be point on the parabola. So I am making sure that it is at a distance r1 from a fixed point, and it is at a distance r1 from a fixed line. Similarly, second point on the this which is at a distance rf, the line, vertical line passing from a f point which is at a distance rf from a fixed line. So I will make sure that if I take the f as a center, radius equal to rf, and if I get the point that will be at a distance rf from a fixed point, but rf at a from a fixed line. So same distance from fixed line and fixed point, so that will be the point on the parabola. Similarly, line passing from the 2, which is at a distance r2 from a fixed line. So what I will do now, f as a center, radius equal to r2, I will mark an arc on both the side of a line, that is p2 and p2 dash, p3 and p4 dash, p3 dash, p4 and p4 dash. And the curve I will draw passing from all the points, that will be the parabolic curve. Now, to draw the normal tangent to the parabolic curve, here we have learned about all the four methods of construction of parabola, that is rectangle method, parallelogram method, tangent method, and directrix focus method. All the four methods we have learned for the construction of parabola. Now here we are going to see how to draw the normal and tangent to the parabolic curve, and for that we will draw a two line such that at a f point we will have a 90 degree angle. Here we will draw the two lines such that here at F point we will have a 90 degree angle, and wherever it cuts we will give the name, wherever it cuts the curve we will give the name S, and wherever it cuts the directrix we will give the name T. We will join the ST, or we will draw the line such that it will be tangential at a point S. That will be the tangent to the curve, and line drawn perpendicular to the tangent will be normal to the curve, and N will be the normal to the curve, and ST will be the tangent to the curve. Now moving ahead, we will learn second type of conics, that is hyperbola. Here we have completed the construction of parabolic curve. That was a one type of conics. Another third type of conics that we are going to learn about, that is hyperbola. It is also a conical curve. Why it is known as conics? Again, I would like to remind you that here we are getting the hyperbolic section when the cone is cut by the cutting plane when it is parallel to the axis. So that's why it is a type of conical type of curve, or we can say that conical sections. If we take the section from the cone, we are getting the hyperbolic curve. And by definition, here the definition eccentricity is always greater than 1 for the hyperbolic curve. That means it is a locus of a point moving in a plane such that ratio of its distance from a fixed point to fixed line is always greater than 1. So here you can see the eccentricity, distance from a fixed point to distance from a fixed line, is always greater than 1. When cutting plane is parallel to the axis, inclination of the plane with the cone is less than semicone angle, we get the hyperbola as a section. Here, this is a cutting plane, cuts the cone parallel to the axis, and we are getting the hyperbolic section. Uses of hyperbola. Boyle's law, all of you have learned at your school level. What is the Boyle's law? That is, P is inversely proportional to V. So if we draw the nature of that Boyle's law, then we will get the hyperbolic section. Shape of overhead tank is a hyperbola. Shape of cooling tower in the industry is a hyperbolic section. Now, different methods of drawing the hyperbola. We are going to learn about the three methods for construction of hyperbola, that is rectangle method, oblique method, and directrix focus method. Here also I will explain you all the three methods by taking the example one by one. We will learn the three methods for the construction of hyperbola, that is one type of conical section or conical shape of the curve. We are getting the hyperbola. Again, I would like to remind you that we are getting the hyperbolic section when we cut the cone with a particular position of the cutting plane, that is parallel to the axis. And eccentricity in case of hyperbola is always greater than 1. First method, rectangle method, we will learn with this example. Two fixed straight line OA and OB are at a right angle to each other. Point P is at a distance of 20 mm from OB and 50 mm from OA. Draw the rectangular hyperbola passing through the point P. Now here I would like to mention that when the asymptotes are at a right angle to each other, hyperbola which is drawn is a rectangular hyperbola. So first we will draw the two lines OA and OB. Point P position is given to us. ...50 mm and 20 mm. So we will mark the point according to the given data. Then we will draw a line from a point. First I have marked the point, the horizontal distance, horizontal or x coordinator, we can say that 20, and y coordinate we can say that 50. So at a distance on the x coordinate 20 and on the y coordinate 50, by taking that, first we will mark the point P0, and after marking the point P0, we will draw the vertical as well as horizontal line passing from point P0. Now we will take the number of points on a horizontal line and we'll draw the lines passing from that points from origin O. So we'll draw the number of lines passing from the points which we have taken on the horizontal line. Now, wherever that line, suppose I am taking the line drawn from O, that is 0, and passing from 1, this line if I am taking, wherever it cuts this vertical line, I will give the number. So, wherever it cuts this O1 line, from where I will draw the horizontal line, and wherever it cuts the horizontal line, I will draw the vertical line. Wherever these two lines meet, that is a line on the parabola. Again, I repeat for this, for the line drawn from 0 to 2. Suppose here the line is intersecting or meeting in a line on the horizontal line to the point 2. So from this point 2, I will draw, which is at a horizontal line, I will draw a vertical line. And intersecting the same line on the vertical line, I will draw the horizontal line. So this line drawn from 0, which is meeting the vertical point 2 dash on the vertical line. So from 2 dash I have drawn the horizontal line, and which is meeting on the 2 on the horizontal line. So from 2 I have drawn the vertical line. So here I would like to say that the points wherever the line meets the points on the horizontal line, from there we will draw the vertical line, and wherever line meets the point marks on the vertical line, from there we will draw the horizontal line. Wherever this vertical as well as horizontal line meets, there will be the intersection point which is on the parabola. Similarly, from all the points, and here you can draw the smooth arc from all the points passing from the all the points we have got. We can draw the smooth curve with single stroke, and that is our required rectangular hyperbola. Again, I would like to remind you that 2 O and OB which you have drawn, which is at a 90 degree angle, then this type of curve is known as rectangular hyperbola. This is the first method of construction for the rectangular, for the hyperbola, that is rectangular hyperbola. We'll move another method for the construction of hyperbola, that is oblique hyperbola. Similar way we can construct the hyperbola. Here the ONOB, that is two line, is not at a right angle, it is at a some different angle, and we are getting the hyperbola that is oblique. So here we are having a coordinates point, similar coordinates, 20x and 50 or 30, whatever the distance given from the on the y coordinate vertical line. Similarly, we can mark the one point over here, and from that point, that is, this is a given point for which you will be given the x and y coordinate, and from that you have to draw the parallel line to x and y, that is O and OB line, which is for the oblique hyperbola. You are given this angle, and that's why you are drawing the parallel line to O and OB from that given points. Coordinates are also given, and this angle is also given to you. And similarly, you have to draw the different line passing from 0, wherever it intersect the vertical line, draw the horizontal line from there, and wherever it intersect the horizontal line, draw the vertical line from there. Suppose it this you have drawn one line from the 0, wherever it intersect this line, draw the horizontal line from here, and wherever it intersect the horizontal line, draw the vertical line from here. Wherever these two line intersect, that will be the point on the hyperbola. First we are drawing the different lines, and we'll try to get the different points. See here, so first point I have marked, I'm taking the first line which is drawn from the 0. it is intersecting this vertical line in the one dash point and horizontal line in a one point. So I'm drawing the horizontal line from here, vertical line from here. Wherever these two intersect, I will get the point on the hyperbola. And draw the smooth curve from the points you have obtained from all the points. That is oblique hyperbola. Here OA and OB at a some angle and not at a right angle. Now moving to the third methods of construction of the hyperbola, that is directrix focus method for construction of hyperbola. Here I will explain that method, that is directrix focus method for construction of hyperbola, with this example. Here the distance of fixed point is given to you, that is 50 mm, and eccentricity is also given to you, that is 3/2 eccentricity, which is greater than 1 in the case of hyperbola, which is given to you. So distance of point F is given to you and eccentricity is given to you, and in this problem you have to draw the locus of point F, point P moving in a plane such that ratio of its distance from a fixed point to fixed line remains constant and equal to 3/2. You have to construct that curve, that is locus of a moving point. So let's construct the hyperbola with the directrix focus method. First, I will draw the vertical line as a fixed line directrix. Perpendicular to this fixed line, I will draw another line which is axis for the hyperbola. Then I will mark the focus F at a distance 50 mm. So this, for marking the focus F1, this distance, that is CF, is given to you, that is the distance of fixed point from the directrix is 50 mm given to you. Here I would like to mention again that distance of a fixed point will be given to you and eccentricity also will be given to you, and you have to mark or you have to find the locus of point P moving in a plane such that eccentricity, which is greater than 1, is remains constant always for the this type of conic sections. Here now vertex V is marked according to the eccentricity. So in the case of 3, in the ratio of 3/2, so this distance will remain 30 here in this case, because this distance, total distance CF1, is given 50. So I will mark the V point at a distance of 30 and CV will be at a distance of 20 mm from 20 mm distance, right? So such that the ratio of eccentricity will remain 3/2. Now maintaining that ratio, I will draw same distance, that is I will draw the vertical line from point V, that is V, the same distance, that is VF1. Then from the joining from the C point, I will draw another line and extend it. Then take the number of points on the axis nearly at an equal distance. I will take the number of points 1, 2, 3, 4. You can take more number of points. Always go for a more number of points. You will have an accurate curve. If you have to join two points which is far ahead, then you will have a not accurate locus. If you have to join two points which is at a small distance, then you may get the accurate locus. So always go for more number of points and your locus or curve will be accurate. So here on the axis, you have to take the number of points nearly at an equal distance. Then draw vertical lines from all the points intersecting the line drawn from C. And here you can give the name 1-1, 2-2, 3-3, maintaining that ratio. And these are the points on the hyperbola. So we have got all the points including this vortex. Again, I would like to remind you, this total CF1 distance is 50 mm, this VF1 distance is 30 and CV distance is 20. So we are maintaining the ratio. So that's why V point is marked at a 30 mm distance from F and 20 mm distance from C, and maintaining the eccentricity 3/2. So including this vertex, you have to draw the smooth curve from all the points. While joining the curve, again I will say that you have to draw the curve in a single stroke. You need not have to dark again and again it. With a single stroke, you can use initially French curve for drawing locus or curve, so that you can draw the curve accurately in a single stroke. You need not have to draw all this construction line. You need not have to rub all this construction line. They are required, but all this construction line, they are not actual line, so it will be a faint line, as you have learned in a types of line. So it will be thin line, faint line. All this construction line should not be dark one. Only locus is highlighted, that is your required curve should be highlighted, and for that you should not dark it again and again. In a single stroke, with a one stroke smooth curve, all the points are joined with the help of French curve. Initially you may use that for joining the different points. Now again, we are learning how to draw the normal and tangent to the hyperbola. So here we are drawing the two lines such that we can have a right angle at a F point. Wherever it cuts the directrix, that will be T1. Wherever it cuts the curve, that is hyperbola, that will be S point. And from the joining the TS, join the TS, T1S, and such that draw the line such that it will be tangential to the curve and perpendicular to the TS1 line, which is tangential to the curve, that will be the normal to the curve. This is a normal and this is a tangent to the curve. So this is how we can draw normal and tangent to the curve. Here we have learned the different methods for the hyperbola. I am concluding this different methods for the parabola. So by this time you have learned the all the three conical types of curve, that is ellipse, hyperbola and parabola, in different methods for construction of ellipse, hyperbola and parabola, and use of it, of course. And in the next session you will learn about the second group of curve, that is cycloidal group of curve.